So we have the vector a being equal to 5, comma negative 6. So if we wanted to visualize that, we could start at the tail of vector a, and we'd want to move 5, positive 5 in the x direction, so that'd be 5 to the right based on our conventions. And we'd want to move negative 6 in the y directions, and based on our conventions, that would be 6 down. 6 down, so this length would be 6. If this was a positive 6, we would have moved 6 up over here. This length over here is 5. And so going 5 to the right and then 6 down, would take us from the tail to the head. So now we are at the head, or sometimes, well, I'll just call it the head, or I guess you could say the tip or the arrow side of the vector. So let's draw it just like that. So that's a reasonable representation for our vector A. So let's see, what else can we think about? How else can we think about this vector? Well, what if we wanted to figure out its magnitude? Well, the magnitude of this vector is just the length of this arrow, if we think of it visually, and this is a right triangle. So this is really just, we just need to figure out the length of the hypotenuse of this right triangle, where we know the lengths of the two shorter sides. So the magnitude of vector A is just going to be equal to the square root, this is coming straight out of the Pythagorean theorem, square root of 5 squared plus 6 squared. Plus 6 squared, which is equal to the square root of, let's see, 25 plus 36 is 61. So the length of this arrow right over here is square root of 61, which is a little bit under 8, which actually just makes visual sense. So that was interesting. Let's say we want to do something else. Let's say we wanted to figure out some unit vector that goes in the same direction as A. So it's a unit vector, so that means that its length is 1, but it goes in the same direction as A. Well, we've seen this before. If we call this unit vector u, and I'll put the little hat on top of it to show that it's a unit vector, what we could do is we could take vector a and divide it by, essentially scale it down by the magnitude of vector a. Or another way of thinking about it, this would be equal to, so this part right over here, this would be, we could rewrite this, so let me write it just so we don't get confused, or we could write it like this. We could say 1 over the magnitude of vector a times vector a. And so this makes it pretty clear we're just scaling vector a. So this part right over here, that's going to be equal to 1 over the square root of 61. We figured out that this was already the square root of 61. And we're going to multiply it times vector a, which is 5 comma negative 6. 5 comma negative 6. And so now we can scale it up, or scale it down in this case, by just multiplying the scalar times each of these components. So u is equal to, 5 over the square root of 61, comma, all I'm doing is I'm scaling each of the components in the x direction and the y direction by 1 over square root of 61, comma, negative 6 over the square root of 61. So that was interesting. But now let's ask ourselves another question. What would we have to multiply u by to get to a? What scalar could we multiply it by to get a? Well, our answer is actually right over here. We see that the vector u is equal to the vector a essentially divided by the scalar. So if you multiply both sides times the scalar, you get the magnitude of a, which is just a number, it's just a length of this side, times our unit vector u is going to be equal to our original vector. So if we wanted to write our original vector kind of broken up this way, we could say that our original vector is equal to its magnitude, is equal to square root of 61, times our unit vector, and that makes sense. The length of this unit vector is one square root of 61th of this entire length right over here. And this, of course, is going to be the same thing as the square root of 61, times all of this business. So copy and paste times all of that business. And I think it might jump out at you. If you multiply the scalar, you're going to multiply it times each of these components, you're going to be left with 5, comma negative 6. Now, the whole reason why I did this is just to make you a little bit more comfortable with the different ways of manipulating these notations. Sometimes when you see this type of thing with this, you know, these kind of double lines on either side, it looks like something very fancy. But it's really just talking about the magnitude of the vector, the length of the vector. And so the whole point of this is just to relate the vector itself to the magnitude of the vector to a unit vector going in the same direction.